camera really doesn't want me to film today. It doesn't want me to just stay. Oh my gosh. I think we got it. Okay. All right. Hey guys. So today I decided I would do a simple smoky black eye, just to show you guys how to do it for beginners and stuff. But I also just last minute I thought, let me do like a chit chat, get ready with me kind of thing whilst I'm doing it. And so I'm gonna be looking down because my mirror is here, so excuse me if I'm just talking and you can't really see me talking. It's because I'm looking down the mirror. But yeah, let's get started. All right, so as usual I'm using my Fawn LA Girl Pro concealer just to set my eyes for my foundation for my eyeshadow. So I'm going to use this, and I'm going to be using my Ben Nye banana powder to set this concealer. So yeah, let's get on with it. And so today guys, I thought we should talk about just like feeling like, I don't know, you're worth it. I don't really know how, where this chit chat's gonna go, but yeah, so I'm just gonna get into it. But I'm not, with this chit chat, I'm not really gonna give lots of information, just because this is quite a like, so basically make more sense. Okay, so I just started a new job in a school, and the reason why I'm not gonna give a lot of information is because I've just started this job, and obviously I really like it and I want to keep the job. I don't want no problems. But just recently in the job, I've just been feeling like, you know, I like all the staff there are lovely. I love all of them. Like some of them, I feel like they're going to be my friends and like for a long time. And, you know, and I'm really grateful for that, because all the other schools I've worked at, you know, it's been very hard for me to fit in. A lot of the people that worked at the schools that I last worked in were like older than me. Because, you know, I'm only 19, and it's like rare to come across somebody as young as me working in a school. And so like a lot of them are, you know, old enough to be my grandparents and to be my parents, so it was hard for me to like fit in. So when I started working at this school, I you know, met people my, like, well, not my age, but close to my age. And so I was like, praise God, wow, like there's a lot of people that I can relate to. And not only that, but my friend also works at this school, and so that was really nice to have somebody that I know. So like that was like a blessing from God. And so I just started working in this school, as I've said, but in this school there is like a different way of doing things. Normally you'd have like a class teacher and a TA, a teaching assistant, and sometimes you'll have like a one-to-one teacher that will work with like a child that needs more help, like maybe an autistic child or somebody that just has finds it hard academically. And so in this school it's different. So there's two teachers, there's two classes for each year group. So say you work in year one, there'll be one class with one teacher, and there'll be another class with another teacher, and so that would be their teacher. But then all together they're a team. And then there'll be a senior teacher, which is basically the teacher that looks over them and makes sure they're doing the right thing, basically. And then there'll be a TA. But what's the trick about this is the TA is a TA for both classes. So basically you end up being a TA for about 64 children, so that's all the kids put together. And so it's much harder, because normally you'd find a school where there would be, you know, a TA for each class, so that you're just allocated to one class. But this one is two, so it's hard to kind of like juggle it, but it's also a challenge. And I really do like it. At first I was a bit like, whoa, what's this? But I do like it. But yeah, so as I was saying, so basically us four teachers, we're like a team, and we basically work together just for the, you know, for the kids' education and stuff, and just being together. And recently I've just been feeling a bit like kind of left out. So I'm using my Morphe palette, the 35W one. I always use this palette, I love it. First of all, doing it from camera. First of all, I'm going to use this brown color right here. Just just up here just for a nice transition color. But yeah, so recently I've just been feeling like I don't fit in really with like the teachers and stuff, because you know, obviously I'm new, they all knew each other before I came, and so they all had that kind of bond already. But I guess we were all kind of new as a team, because obviously we've all never worked all together. At first I wasn't really bothered, I was just like, you know, yeah, well I'm new, this is what it's going to be like. Like, of course I can't expect to fit in straight away. But then it's like every single time I work at a school, it's like the devil really tries it with me. He really tries to make me feel like, oh, you don't fit here, oh, you don't belong anywhere, oh, these people don't like you, like you don't, you're not accepted here basically. And I never used to feel like that. Like when I started working here, I really loved it, and I still do, like don't get me wrong. But I've just been starting to feel like, you know, like I don't fit in. And I had a chat with my mum yesterday, and she was basically like to me, Renee, like, you know, you can't do things for, you can't go to the school and, you know, kind of do things for people to see you and be like, oh, Renee, you know, look, you're doing this and you're doing that. And because this is, I'm not making sense right now because I'm not explaining it properly. Okay, let me go back. What I was saying to mum also was that not only did I feel like I didn't fit in, but I felt like I wanted them to see what I was doing. I wanted them to see that I was doing a lot of work and I was really working hard. And I wanted them to acknowledge that, basically. Because, you know, I felt like I did a lot of things and they didn't see. And I work really hard. Like, I've, you know, obviously being a Christian and stuff, you, not just that, but just growing up as well, my parents have always taught me, do things to the best of your ability. It says that in the Bible, do things with all your might, like do it. Don't just do things half-heartedly, like do things with all your might. If you're gonna do it, why not do it with everything? And so that's how I am. And so I work really hard, and I feel like sometimes they don't see that. And so so guys, I'm moving on to this. What shade did I, yes, this color right here, yeah, just above that. Yeah, so I would always do things, they feel like, oh my gosh, if only they can see it, and I would try and do it so they can see. And that kind of thing isn't good. Mom was saying to me that, you know, you're ultimately, I know this is for man, like you're working for man, but when you do things, you're doing it for God, you're doing it to please God, for God's glory. This isn't for man to see what you're doing. And I understand that, you know, obviously you want them to see that you're working hard and you're doing things and, you know, you're going out of your way to do things, but this is not for them to see. And if you can do it for God, and if you can please God, imagine, God is the one that gave you this job in the first place. You know what I mean? Like, God is the one that made this possible for you. So don't do things for man, do things for the acceptance of God, not for the acceptance of what people are going to think about you. Because at the end of the day, they are people. They're people just like you. And, you know, sorry guys, I'm just moving on to this orangey color just to warm it up a bit, and this is going just above that color I just put there, so just really really close to my eyebrow. Yeah. And so when I said that, I was like, wow, like all this time I've been like kind of blinded by, you know, doing things for the acceptance of others and wanting them to see what I'm doing, and I'm not realizing that, you know, Jesus deserves all the glory and everything, every single thing. As soon as you lose sight of that, you start to you know, feel discouraged, you start to, the blessing that God is giving you starts to get covered by how you're feeling. And feelings are just an emotion. Like, feelings have the power to just take over everything. Feelings have the power to forget, make you forget that who God is. Like, oh, it's just mad. And so once I got that like once mom told me, I started thinking like, wow, like I need to just work for God, and I just need to work for God to see that I'm doing it, and I know He does. And so why am I so like getting so uptight and working myself up because a man can't see me? Like, that just sounds, and the thing is, when you hear it from somebody else, it sounds so silly, and it makes you seem like all this time I didn't see that. And so yeah, I thought I'd just like kind of speak about that. And yeah, I thought I'd just kind of give you guys like a little gist on that, just, you know, just in case some of these out there, they struggling or whatever, and I thought it'd be a good thing to like kind of talk about for you guys. So now I'm moving on to, never organized for my videos, moving on to my Kiko eyeliner lasting gel, and I'm just gonna put this on my eyelids for my smoky eye, and I'm gonna start, you know, slaying myself. But yeah, that's it really. That's what I really wanted to like tell you guys. I'm gonna just use this little brush and I'm just gonna dip it in there, basically start applying it to my eyelid in soft small dabs. Yeah, small dabs. But yeah, that's how I've been feeling. But other than that, guys, I really love my job. Like, you know, God has blessed me so much. Like, I've worked in 5 schools. Can you believe that? 5 schools, and I'm only 19 years old. And I'm so grateful. God has been so good to me. I can't thank him enough. Like, I'm telling you, like, when people are talking about all this, God isn't real. Like, you can't tell me there isn't a God in heaven. All the blessings he's done for me. I'm not even in my 20s yet, like, and God has really blessed me. Like, he is wonderful, so wonderful. And you know, this is the start of a beautiful year, and I have so many plans. Like, I really, something that's really a big passion of mine is to one day hopefully have my own clothing line. And I'm very, I don't know, like, I'm very a bit like, oh, like, I'm saying it, but I don't really believe in myself, which is bad. So I'm just gonna keep praying about it. But because, you know, I from people that know me know that I'm really short, so I'm petite, or what they would call petite. So I really wanted to like have like a clothing line with petite people, because I find it so hard to find clothes for myself, especially like simple things like trousers. Like, they're too long or they're too big for me, and it's just very annoying sometimes. And so I thought, let me just start a, why don't I start like a clothing line? But yeah, I just need to like start researching how I'm gonna go about doing that, because I know I don't want to be in a like working in a school for the rest of my life. I know that there's so much more things that I'd like to do. Yeah, sorry guys, just gonna blend that out with this brush. But yeah, I know there's so much more that I want to do with my life. And I also, this is something that I really want to do, and hopefully I will. I also want to have my own hairline, because, you know, I love hair. Like, I love just weave and just like hair and everything hair. And so if I had my own hairline, like, I would just be so happy. Especially as, you know, you would know what you're getting, and I know how it feels to like get some rubbish hair and expect it to be really nice, and like you spend all this big money on like hair you think is going to be amazing, and then it's just rubbish. And so I feel like I'll come from a really good like a lot of experience from like hair and stuff. So God willing, this will all come to pass one day. And as you guys can see, I'm taking the eyeliner up quite high so that it can smoke out a bit, just because I got hooded eyes, so you can't really see much. But yes, I'm taking it up a bit high, you guys can see. But yeah, I have a lot of ambitions for this year, guys. I really want to start learning how to drive too, because, you know, your girl can't drive, which is very bad. That is like very bad. But hopefully I can start driving, because yeah, it needs to start. Like, this isn't good. But I'm gonna concentrate on smoking this out now, because this bit is really hard. So I'm just gonna insert some music and just like speed it up a bit. And yeah, I'll see y'all. You know, you guys are gonna still watch me anyway, so you get what I mean, you get what I mean. We'll be right back. just wanted to say, I just did have a thought, like, prayer is so important. Like, prayer, and I know it's such a random thing to just like say, but I just, like, this year I've realized, or not just this year, but like, I really realized that prayer is so important. Like, you can't just expect things to happen if you don't pray. Like, and it sounds so simple, but many times people forget that all you need to do is pray. Like, all they want to do is want to go on Google, look up solutions for things, and just find ways, when all you need to do is ask a loving God that has, like, loves you, for help, or for forgiveness, or for, you know, just, do you know what I mean? Like, it's just prayer. It's so important. And, you know, oh my gosh, you guys need to watch that film, War Room. Oh my gosh, I watched that film once, I think, and that one time I still haven't forgotten what that film was like. That film would teach you about prayer so much, and just like how the importance of prayer. The woman basically had, like, she would have, like, pieces of paper that she'll put her prayers on, and she basically turned her closet into her prayer room, which is what they call her war room, because all her battles, everything that she was warring with, basically was put on those pieces of paper and stuck to her wall. And she would go into that room every day and she would pray. And it's so good when you can actually, like, write your prayers down, and actually, you know, obviously, you know, we're not all balling to, like, have some our own, like, closet for our prayers. Like, obviously you can pray anywhere, but yeah, so she, yeah, I'm so bad, guys. Like, I'm really so bad. I'm really so sorry if this video is rubbish, but I'm so bad, I always forget what I'm gonna say. But yeah, we're not all bawling to have some prayer room, but like, it's good to see your prayers on paper, and it just, like, kind of reminds you that what you're warring through, and when that prayer does get answered, you can take that off, and you can and then you'll be able to see that God has actually answered your prayer. And, you know, sometimes with prayers, it's kind of a hard one, because people claim they're Christians, and they claim that, oh yeah, just pray to God, but then themselves, they don't have the faith. And many times, it's so bad, it happens to me, it happens to all of us, where we pray and we're just praying in vain. We don't know, we don't think it's going to happen. We don't pray thinking, yes, God is going to come through for me, he's going to bless me, he's going to do this. We just pray because, you know, it's the thing to do, and yeah, as a Christian, that's what you do. But when you pray and you actually believe it, it makes such a difference, and the power that comes out of it. And sometimes your prayers don't get answered straight away, but God always has a plan. And sometimes you think your prayers haven't been answered, but they have. You just can't see it because it's not exactly what you prayed for. It's not exactly what you want. But you have to remember that God has our best interest at heart, and He knows us. Like, He created us, so He knows what's best for us. So we can't always be, you know, expecting God to give us exactly what we want. And also, sometimes your prayers don't get answered, but God knows what He's doing. And I always say this, and this is something I always stick to, is that everything happens for a reason. Good or bad, it happens for a reason. So, like, you could literally, I don't know, lose your job. Anything could happen to you. You could get hurt, go into hospital. But even though it's a bad situation, God is always in control. And it may seem like, oh yeah, God's just gonna make me get hit by a car, God's gonna make me lose my job. What kind of God is that? But He knows what He's doing. Like, when one door closes, another door opens, and that's just God. Like, when I left my last job, it was like literally walking distance. I could walk there. It was 5 minutes away from my house, and it was amazing. I loved it. I loved the job. Everything about it was really good. But then, because I work with an agency, it's not always guaranteed that you're going to be working at the school for long unless the school decides to keep you on as their staff and basically buy you out. But that costs like thousands of pounds for them to buy you out of your contract with the agency. So sometimes they're not always willing to do that. Sometimes they don't have the money. And that's what happened with my school, or my last school. And so I had to leave, and I was very sad. Like that whole week, I was like praying, like God, please, please, like I really want to stay here. This is so ideal for me. I don't have to pay for travel. Like if I stay at this school, if they decide to keep me, like God, please speak to them. Like just I was really contending, and I was really praying. And another thing is what I didn't do is what I didn't tell anyone that I wanted them to pray. So sometimes when, even though when you pray it's powerful, sometimes when other people pray with you it's even more, and it just reinforces it much more. And so that's another thing, like if you want something, tell your friends, you know, guys, like, you know, I really want this, and I, you know, can you please pray for me, help me to pray for this. Pray together. Sometimes when you pray together it's so powerful, the feeling after, you just feel like it's your prayer's been answered straight away. But I was praying, and I was like, God, please, I want this job, please, it's so ideal for me. And I ended up not staying there. I was upset for a moment, but I realized, you know what, God knows what he's doing. And now I work at the school I work at now, and even though I was telling you guys about how I'm feeling left out, I feel like that's just the devil, and that's just him trying to talk to me and trying to get into my head, because I really do actually love this job. The people, everything about it is amazing. Obviously it's further for me to get to, and it's obviously it's travel money that I'm spending, but God has really truly helped me through. And everyone, like my last school was a bit, you know, antisocial, but this one, everyone is so lovely, so nice, such nice people, man. Like they are absolutely wonderful, and I haven't even known them for that long, but they are so cool. But yeah, prayer is really, 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 really important. I think so, anyway. My silly American accent that I can't even do. But oh my gosh, guys, as well, I'm almost on 200 subscribers. Oh my gosh. Thank you guys so much. Like, even though it doesn't seem like nothing, it really, 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 really does mean a lot to me. I really do appreciate it. I really, really want to get to the point where YouTube can be like kind of like a career for me. Not like a career, but something that I can grow from, and you guys can grow from, and other people can grow from, and it can be something that I can use to speak to people, like a bit of a platform. And I want to get to the point where it can be like I said, a career for me. I can do it for a living, because you know this is something I really love to do. I really like editing videos. Like I really like when I edit my videos and just speaking to you guys and just giving you what I know. And like I'm not the best person out there, like I'm not the wisest person, but I can only give you what I know and what I've experienced. And so yeah, it really does mean a lot to me. Thank you so much, guys. Continue to share, like, comment, subscribe, and I really do appreciate it. But I'm telling you guys, being a YouTuber, especially like a small-time YouTuber, is so hard. Like, you have to be so consistent. Your videos have to be like, you gotta have a video every week. Like, you gotta be on the ball. Like, there's none of this messing around. Like, it doesn't work. And so it really has taught me about being consistent and stuff, and it's just very hard, but I'm willing to do it for y'all. And you know, it's just hard putting yourself out there on like a platform as well, because you're putting yourself out there to be judged and for people to say things. But you know, only, as we always say, only God can judge me. So, and obviously criticism is good. Criticism is always good. It's always good to hear what people have to say, because especially from like when it's from, if you guys were to give me criticism, like it's from you guys. You guys are ultimately the ones watching this, so this is basically for you. It's not really for me. It is for me, because actually sometimes I do the things I say, it surprises me, because I'm learning as I'm speaking, if that makes sense. And so yeah, it is good to have criticism. Well, what it has taught me is that I'm very, 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 like, I'm a very stubborn kind of person. So, like, when people try to give me criticism, I get upset. I'm like, oh, you don't like my videos. Oh, and don't tell me, don't talk to me about my videos if you have nothing nice to say. But that's not reality. And as I'm becoming an adult, I'm learning that, you know, you need to hear things. And if I'm putting myself out there, I'm gonna get, people are gonna have things to say. There's nothing I can do about that, and I just need to get over it, really, and stop being a baby. But yeah, oh, right now, guys, I'm just putting on highlighter. I've got two highlighters and just putting that on the bridge of my eyebrow, you know, on the bridge of my eyebrow. Is that the right thing to say? Or the, what's it called, what's this thing, the, whatever this bit is here, I'm putting it there, okay? But yeah, and now I'm just going to go back in with my under eye, like just to come back in with my under eye shadow and just to smudge it out. And yeah, I'm just going to speed up this part of the video just because I'm going to be really focused. I need to stop doing American accents because I'm not good at it. But yeah, so I'm just going to speed this up, guys. So bear with me, bear with me.